We are now going to analyze a few cabinets and see how we can describe them in the LEM editor. We are not going to change any components properties yet because I'd like to focus on the way components networks are created. This is the goal of this video. Our first candidate will be the well-known G-Sub. This cabinet holds two 18-inch drivers in a bass reflex configuration. Luckily for us, there is a component doing exactly what we need in the LEM editor. It is the enclosure vented component. What we want to do next is to add the two speakers components. They are called LEDIN drivers and are located in the transducer EA category. This component is standard and will work for almost any speaker, no matter the diameter. Let's now see how to connect them together. This cabinet got the rear side of the two speakers located inside the vented enclosure. To describe this to Akabak, in the schematic editor, we will connect the rear sides of the LEDIN drivers to this vented enclosure component. We can also note that the front faces of the speakers are radiating outside of the cabinet. And in order to represent this, we will need to use another component called radiator, to which we connect the front sides of the speakers. The only thing left to do is to power our two speakers, and for this, you will need to have some basic knowledge about electricity. We will grab two components, the source and the GND, which means ground, and they correspond to the positive and negative terminal of a virtual amplifier. Whether you want the two speakers connected in series or in parallel is up to you, and in my case, I will connect the two speakers in parallel in order to divide the total impedance by two. If you want to add a bit of realism to your simulation, you can add a resistor with a small value between the power source and the speaker in order to simulate the effect of a long cable between the amplifier and the cabinet, since it is often the case in reality. The next example will be based on a PowerFlex from the HOQS community. The typology of this cabinet is quite different from our first example, so let's study how sound waves propagate through it. As always, sound originates from the speaker. On its front side, the waves will propagate through a volume forming the letter C, before meeting the waves of the rear side of the speaker to then exit the cabinet. The simplest way to describe this to Akabak is to first decompose this rear volume into three parts that have a constant area over their length. This will bring us to use a component called duct. If you have a good eye, you're probably wondering why I said three parts, even though the first and second one have the same area across their length. So let me show you why. The first duct is located on the right side of the speaker, while the second one is on the left side. And this detail will allow us in Akabak to connect the speaker's front side in between the two, thus correctly indicating the offset position of the speaker. Finally, the volume behind the speaker can also be described as three ducts. There is one on the left side of the speaker, one from the speaker to the output of our first duct network, and one from this point to the outside of the cabinet. Once again, we are splitting this last duct because we want to indicate to the software where the sound waves will merge together on average. If you want to make your schematic clearer, like me, you can rotate the components by selecting them and hitting Ctrl plus R, or right-click on it and rotate. This will give us a nice visual representation of the cabinet shape so we don't get lost with all these components. And indeed, you might have guessed it, since this last duct connects to a space outside of the cabinet, we will need to add a radiator component. Once again, connect the speaker to a source and a GND component, and the cabinet is successfully described to Akabak. If you want to add a bit of realism to your simulation, you can add an acoustic mask component between ducts of different areas, such as here. Our third and last example will introduce us to the last component you need to know in LEM. This cabinet is called the 1850 horn and is composed of an expanding horn taking place on the front side of the speaker, while its other side is located in a sealed chamber. In ACABAC, this will simply translate to an enclosure component on the speaker's rear side and waveguide component on its front side, plus a radiator to connect the horn to the outside of the cabinet. In reality, it is a bit more complicated. Because the horn have a complex shape, we will need to connect in series many waveguide components to accurately describe its shape to the software. I know the process is tedious, but it's necessary if you want to make your simulation as realistic as possible. A little trick consists of tracing a graph with the length of each segment on the x-axis and its area on the y-axis to see if some waveguides could be merged together, as this would reduce the amount of components in ACABAC without any major compromises on the accuracy. Also, if you want to be as close to reality as possible, you can note that the speaker is mounted below the plank and therefore indicate the presence of a duct wide and very short ahead of the speaker's front face. The same applies on the Paraflex we've seen previously. In the next video, we will focus on setting the physical dimensions of each component we've just seen.